add something extra to your trip down river, ladies and gentlemen, we should like to point out to you some of the places of interest we shall be passing. The large building immediately in front of you is the County Hall, the home of the London County Council and the administrative headquarters of London's government. It is said that the building contains over 5 miles of corridors. The big space that comes immediately after County Hall was where the Festival of Britain took place in 1951. The festival exhibition stretched from here along the riverbank to Waterloo Bridge, which is the second bridge we shall be passing under. Though you can still see some reminders of the festival, the air has changed a lot since then. The biggest change was caused by this white stone building you are just beginning to see. This is the European headquarters of the Royal Dutch Shell Petroleum Company and one of the largest office buildings in London. It is in front of the Shell building that the new National Theatre will be built in a few years' time. You can see the roof of a building which looks like an aircraft hangar. This is in fact the Royal Festival Hall, one of the finest concert halls in Europe. You will get a better view of it as we pass under the bridge. As you can see, a lot of work is going on around the festival hall. This work is to improve the hall and to make another small concert hall and art gallery next to it. When this work is completed, the South Bank will be the cultural centre of London. You may also notice that the National Film Theatre is also part of this area. You may just catch it as we pass under Waterloo Bridge, for it is built directly underneath the bridge.
Thank you. shall not desert them, nor sacrifice their interests to any spirit of time-serving political expediency. We are of the workers. They are our kin. We are part of them. Their battle is our battle. What hurts them hurts us. What they gain, we gain. And remembering the heroism of their toilsome lives, we shall, as a party, seek to create conditions in which the nobler aspirations, which we know to be buried under the load of their poverty, or to be petrified by their sordid surroundings, shall have free play.
Years ago, Queen Victoria opened the Great Exhibition in Hyde Park. The Festival of Britain has been planned, like its great predecessor, as a visible sign of national achievement and confidence. All of us can paint the contrast between the calm security of the Victorian age and the hard experience of our own. Peace has not endured. Two world wars have brought us grievous loss of life and treasure. And though the nation has made a splendid effort towards recovery, new burdens have fallen upon it. Yet this is no time for despondency, for I see this festival as a symbol of Britain's abiding courage and vitality. With the spirit of our ancestors renewed in us, we can, under God's providence, restore and expand the prosperity of which they laid the foundations. We have not proved unworthy of our past, and we can do better in the years ahead.